up, y'all? It's your girl, Jakayla A, and we are going to get into the nails today. That beautiful TikTok you just seen was on these nails. We're not going to do any application in this video. We do that in every video. So, we already done with that. And we're going to go in and do like a red zebra freestyle on Mara. She was going to ride wave, and she said she needs a pop art design mixed with the zebra design. So, what we did on four of the nails that we have our pop art design, we just made the base clear. That's what the acrylic is, clear. And then on the ring finger, we have a glow white powder, and I made that like three videos ago. That's what I'm using here, and that's gonna be our zebra nail. I went down with a red from what is them people over there, D&D, y'all. So, you can see right there what it is. I can't see in my voiceover of this video, but you can zoom in or you could pause and see. It's about four different reds I use from them. This is one of my favorite ones, but they have so many pretty ones. So, it's just a matter of getting you two coats of a nice pretty, or maybe one, depending on the pigment and your polish. Getting you a nice full saturated coat of polish down, or starting with an acrylic base. Like I said, I chose to do polish. Now we're getting into the design. I'm using my Gelixir Black, as I always am, and my very long liner brush that I get from Michaels, as I always am. In this video, I'm gonna try my best to link this brush. I'm actually gonna try my best to link almost every single thing that I use in this video. I don't know how I'm about to do it, because me and Lynx don't get along, but baby, I'm about to try to find it. This the look that we're doing. That's the nail inspiration. Shout out to me being a two-phone mommy now. Two-phone mommy can have one phone in her face and one phone filming the video. Ooh, look at God. It's saving me, y'all. And it's really helping with my consistency. I have been doing videos this fall season. I have so many more in the tuck. It's lit for me. So, yeah, that means it's lit for y'all. So, that means that my content can come more consistently, because I'm not running out of space trying to fiddle around with one phone. Let's talk about the zebra anyway. I just had to go on that rant. The zebra is random. I'm looking at the picture, but I'm not trying to really give the picture. You cannot recreate animal print to a T. Animal print is meant to be random. It's meant to be kind of its own unique thing. It's like a snowflake. No cheetah, it has the same spots. No zebra has the same lines. So animal print is one of the most forgiving and easiest, cutest things to put into your freestyles if you need accent nails, because it is meant to be random. You really can't really fuck it up, for real, for real. You really can't do it wrong. It's kind of meant to be done wrong. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's meant to be its own special, unique thing. So I went ahead and just did that randomly. You'll see the other nail is going to end up very different than that one. And what you want to do with this border is, the long brush saves me with this, y'all. Like, y'all see how I'm picking it up and just going around and around, but it's kind of making it flush. The long brush saves me with this style. You want the lines on the edge, on the sides, excuse me, to be thick enough to the point that you could see them looking straight on, but no thicker. And you want to keep your cuticle clean. You see, I just cleaned mine up. You want to keep it very clean with that black line. It probably would have saved me to use a red acrylic instead of two polishes on top of each other, because that bolt wouldn't have been there. But, you know, it still worked out in the end. You just want to keep your sides very smooth when you're doing your red gel polish or whatever color you use. And you want to keep your black line very smooth. That's why you should use a paint pot or a thick, full saturated black, something like this Gelixir Black. You want to use something real nice and hardy, nothing watery. And look at this zebra. This zebra even came out even cuter to me than the other one. This one is a little bit more on a slant. And yeah, it's just cute. You know, animal print for the win every time for me. Something I didn't mention is, in the deep left corner, we did two black lines. You saw them in the TikTok, and you'll see them in the close-up later. But don't forget those two lines. Real simple, real easy. So I'm going with my white, and I'm starting at the middle of the top of the cuticle area. I'm literally looking at it, and I'm just gauging whatever is the middle. That's where I'm starting my line, and then I'm whipping it down. I did my half. As you see, I picked my brush up, and then I brought my line down. If your line work is on a on point, baby, you could swoosh that whole line down in one pass. You wouldn't even have to pick your brush up. But like I said, I'm still learning and I'm still practicing my artwork and my line work. So you do the line and then you do a dot at the bottom. It's so many ways to add highlights. Literally just Google this challenge, look it up. Not even Google it. Get on Instagram, get on TikTok, or here on YouTube. Look up this trend. Sorry, not a challenge, it's a trend. And find whatever highlights you like. These are the black lines and the white lines that I like. When I looked at them, everybody did them different. Everybody put their own stamp and their uniqueness on it. But this is the way that I liked it when I saw it. And it also was within my scope of my abilities. You know what I'm saying? You could challenge yourself, or also you could pick something that just works for you. It don't even be deep. It really don't. So this is what I like, and the effect is beautiful to me. I thought it was super cute. And so yeah, that's what I decided to do. Period. With my top coat, I think I'm good to go, but I'm not, because my thumb is not dry. So I wiped all of that off, put some acetone on a napkin, and wipe all of that uncured area off and redo it. It is okay to have to start over. It is okay for something to be messed up in real time, in the moment, when you're in your appointment. If it is not coming together easy peasy lemon squeezy, stop for a minute and do it over. I found that I didn't even have to put on no more red. It was just my black line that didn't cure, because my light is very small. My light is small and the base of it is not mirrored. If you're getting an LED lamp, try to get one that's mirrored. I was more focused on getting one that's rechargeable. It's not the Kiara Sky, because that one is mirrored. That baby is still on my bucket list. I'm still getting that baby at some point. But yeah, I got one off Amazon, and yeah, it's okay to mess up. It's okay. It's okay to mess up. It's okay to start over. So that's what I did. I cleaned it up and I started over. And then I've been oiling up the hand lately. Like, I put the cuticle oil on, then I oil up the hand. And that's the finished look. Hope y'all like it. Catch you in the next one. Bye.